Well, it's a shame, really. But I think with the surge in commercials all up and down the country, it was inevitable that it was going to happen. That anglers, to fish in a match, they had to be part of the canal scene because that was the scene going back before these commercials all started springing up all over the place, all up and down the country. And to be in a decent match, you'd be on the canal and you'd travel to fish those matches. But now you can fish a match on your doorstep every day of the week, and you haven't got to travel. And I think the canal matches got less and less, and also fishing on commercials, less walking, it's safer, less expense fuel, you're going to catch more fish, and you've got lots of matches on commercials. Bigger matches than what the canal scene was. So I think anglers now they've just dropped away from fishing canals and they're fishing commercials. Same with rivers. I mean, rivers even more so because, I mean, if you had a match here on the local river, you'd probably attract 12 people. Whereas years ago, people didn't have the local commercial, so they'd travel to fish that match. And you'd get 200 people on an open match on the river. Like I say, now you get a dozen maximum. It's just not the in thing anymore. It's just all commercials, and that's where it's at. Well, would you hit a little bloke? No, I've always managed to get away with it. Maybe because of my size. People know if I have a joke. It's just a laugh, and they see the funny side of it. But no, not really. I've not really come close because I've always like people have always seen the funny side, and I've had a good kick out of it, and they have as well. Well, the best one that comes to mind is one I played on Nuddy on Bob Nudd. We were fishing a semi-final practice for the Angling Times Winter League down on the Gloucester Canal. And I drew next to Bob, and we was probably 100 pegs away from where the fish were being caught, because them days, I mean, I'm going back probably 16, 17 years, was when it'd be 250 pegs, maybe 300 pegs at a practice, because all the teams would be practicing, all the reserves. And I remember those catching fish on Hempstead Bend, and me and Bob was 100 pegs away. I said, Bob, shall we take a walk and see where they're catching the fish? Just have a little look, you know, it might be helpful information. So I went for a walk. I'd seen enough, and I said, Bob, I'm going to go back and see if I can catch a fish. Bob said, all right, I'll be back in a bit. When I got back, I put a number eight shot on three of Bob's rigs he'd got set up. And it was brilliant because it was Bloodman Joker fishing, and you got the bristle nicely set in the water. Bob's come back, shouted out to me, any good? I said, I think I missed a bite. And Bob's reply was, yeah, well, maybe the roach will start to feed now. I've watched Bob pick his rig up, and as he lowered it in the water, of course, with that number eight shot, the bristle slow, and I see him lift up and strike. I've just missed one, he shouted. Then I see him miss another one. Then I see him pick up another rig and go in, and then he realised, and he shouted at me, Polly, you. Brilliant, that was awesome. Yes, I do. I fished three or four home internationals, which I thoroughly enjoyed. I mean, to represent your country, or to fish for England, or to play cricket for England, it's a great achievement. And I thoroughly enjoyed the three or four home internationals that I fished. But there's the feeder England teams now. I think we've fished two or three teams this year. And we've got one main team in the event that's coming up. Something new that, you know, I may look to try. It might be something I'd probably enjoy doing. It's just a matter of just seeing where I want to go. I thoroughly enjoy my matches that I fish the weekend. I get a great kick out of, well, I've been winning matches ever since I was a junior. And I mean, each match win is an achievement. So, yeah, but I mean, the feeder team is something I may look to maybe have a go at. Well, I've started coaching anglers doing days fishing, corporate days, birthdays, etc. And what I found taking anglers out, even good standard anglers, is something that I took for granted. Feeding is very important, which a lot of anglers think they're feeding right and they're not. And it's very important the way you feed. And also the way you present your bait in lifting and moving your float. It's amazing, little tiny things to me that seem natural, anglers just don't do it. And it's something, if I can teach anglers, I'll get a good kick out of doing this. But it's taught me that things that I naturally do, other anglers don't. And I think with all top anglers, there's things that they do that the average angler doesn't do. And this is what sets them above the others and obviously catches you more fish and puts more fish in the net. I always consider every match you win's a great achievement, but what sticks in my mind, last year we fished it, first time it was run, the World Pairs in Ireland, run by Kevin Locke and Helen Rainsford. Well organised, and Kevin and Helen got tackle sponsorship from Dawa. There was tremendous prizes. It must have been thousands of pounds of a tackle that Dawa sponsored it, and I think they're sponsoring it again this year. And the Lakeland Inland Waterways put £45,000 up for grabs. And it was 30,000, 10,000, 5,000. And then the top 15 after that got £1,000. So I partnered Derek Whelan. Derek had been fishing over there in one of a few festivals. And said, "Polly, it's something we ought to do. You'd love it out there." And I fished it with Derek Whelan and we had a great time. We finished runners-up. We only missed winning it over the week by 4 kilo, which is nothing, just under a kilo a day. But the best day's fishing that I had of the week was I drew at corner grade. I think it was peg 25. And I spoke to Bob Nunn and he said to me, "You might catch a bream." He goes, "But you're looking to catch maybe 2 kilo. And I caught 25 kilo. I caught 12 bream, a couple of eels and some perch, one hybrid. And Derek Whelan phoned me, he didn't believe it. He put the phone down on me because I like a joke. He thought I was joking. When I got back to the pub where we met up, he was doing cartwheels. He just couldn't believe it. And that put us up the front and we led it all the way, I think, to the last day. Or the Thursday, we were overtook by 3 kilo and then we lost another kilo on the last day. But yeah, that was a big achievement. Won a lot of money and had a great time. I think it's because, to me, and I've spoke to a lot of anglers, team fishing has played its part. There's so many matches now, individually you can fish. And I feel, I've done team fishing, won a lot of team fishing, and I get a bigger kick now out of fishing. You've got lots of mini festivals on commercials all up and down the country. You've got Fishermania that's really thriving now. And you've got the Maven Match this that started up. So with all these big events and these little mini festivals, you can have a calendar of fishing matches on your own. And fishing really where you want to. And knowing that you're going to catch fish and not being drawn in such a section where you're scratching around for a few perch. You know, I feel that I don't want to do that anymore. And I feel now the way they're set with all these commercials, you don't have to. And also, fishing individually, being a full-time angler now, I can give my sponsors better coverage, i.e. I can show the baits I'm using, giving Dynamite's coverage on the bank, and Shimano Normark using the tackle and promoting that. And there's a lot more matches to fish every day. Well, an average week, normal week, Monday, I'll sort my tackle out from the weekend. sort of my rigs, tie hooks. Also, I'll spend some time on the computer on my emails because I've got a website, www.markpollardfishingdays.com, where I do corporate days, birthdays, one-to-one coaching. And that's taken off very well. And I get a lot of emails there, which I book my days out, phone the people back. So Tuesdays and Thursdays are my coaching days. Then Wednesdays are fishing open. And then Saturday and Sundays are fishing open. And Friday, then I'll spend time preparing my tackle again, preparing my baits. I'll go over to Stan J Sports at God Manchester, where Stan and Fizz, they sponsor me bait, which is a great help to me because obviously I get through a lot of bait through the course of a year. Then I'll bring my bait back and sort that out and then just get ready for the weekend. But that does change also with festivals, because I fish quite a few festivals. That could take up the whole week or maybe 2 weeks. And also we have trade shows, being full time with Shimano, Normark and Dynamite Baits. I have trade shows that I have to attend up and down the country. Also product testing, which takes up time as well, and product meetings. So the weeks can change, but that's a normal typical week, but they can change and depending what time of year. I do. Obviously, winter time is the worst time when you're doing features and it's so cold that it doesn't become enjoyable. Same with winter time fishing. But yeah, I get a good kick out the media side, especially trying to show people and give them something to read about that they can improve on their fishing. Because I always think with features, it's good to do a feature that is showing people a way of fishing or a method that they can look and try and copy. Or it may work on their fishery where they're fishing, be it river or canal, something to improve their fishing. I mean, we all buy magazines and read magazines to improve our own fishing, and it's nice to have actually read a feature that is going to improve your fishing. To me, if it's not, then why show a feature? Yeah, watercraft is something you can't teach people watercraft. It's something that comes natural over the years of fishing, and I think it's something that's self-taught. But when you've acquired certain points of watercraft, you can tell people about it, and then they can bring it into their own fishing in their own way. I mean, silly things like you could be fishing a match and sweet corn's the bait. And you're not catching, and from a watercraft perspective, all of a sudden you'll think, what if I try three dead red maggots, or instead of sweet corn, I'll put on a piece of punched bread? But something that might work, and you know's worked before, and you know, and it works, and it gets you a few more fish, and it's that watercraft that's got you a few more fish, not just natural ability in fishing a bait. Or fishing a method. It's something you know to do that could trigger off a couple of more fish. And it's something that is self-taught, and it's self-taught over a period of time. It's not something you just suddenly acquire. Well, that is having a family that understands you and a wife that, you know, not just saying this because it's online, but I owe everything to Tracy, my wife. She's been such a rock behind me and supported me in every way, even different family functions that I've missed where I've been fishing. She may have, you know, said a few words about it, but never carried on about it, and fully backed me, and I admire immensely for that. But I've known lots of anglers, and some good anglers that they're probably on their second or third marriage. But I think, you've got a give and take. I mean, my family knows it's me living, and they back me, 200%. At the same time, there's certain things that they require and that I help out with, and I'd go out my way to help them out. And I think that's what's kept us together for 20 years.